all life equally matter. You cannot possibly say black lives matter, but kill all the Muslims. You cannot possibly say any Jewish life matters, but death to all Arabs. You cannot possibly say any blonde baby matters, but kill the Asians. You cannot. And equally, you cannot possibly say every human life matter, but eating corpses, why not? They're only animals. It doesn't work this way. You must all be vegan, stop murdering animals. Otherwise, you have no moral standing, no moral ground to attack people who murder other humans. And similarly, you cannot support a democratic process, democratic protest by people who happen to have dark skin, but then scream against such protests when they are carried out by people who happen to be Muslims, or the other way around. It doesn't work this way. And I mean, just take these few examples. In summer 2019, there was a huge protest here in Israel by the Jews, Israeli Jews, who originally came from Ethiopia. The black Israelis, not matter. And their methods were precisely the same as the methods carried out by the Palestinian citizens of Israel in their protests in the past few days. Precisely. No difference. No difference at all. But yet the reaction by the Israeli majority was totally different. Even keeping in mind that while the Ethiopians are immigrants who chose to come here, not like I'm against it. I'm against the existence of national border and support, and I completely support free immigration from everywhere to everywhere of everybody and everyone. So, Alan was Alan. Everyone wants to come here from Ethiopia, from the Philippines, from Ukraine. I hug them all. However, if you choose to immigrate to a different country, you should accept that for a while, it will take a while until you'll become an equal citizen. Had I been successful in immigrating to the Czech Republic, I wouldn't have accepted the Czech Republic to adjust itself to me just like that. It doesn't work this way. Same goes for people who immigrated to Israel from Russia or Ukraine. They must accept that they are the immigrants. So again, Ahlan wa sahlan, I want them here. I want people here from as many places in the world as possible. But, and the point is, those people who came from Ethiopia received all the love and acceptance in the universe from the local Israelis. Everything. But they still felt that they are discriminated against, unjustly in fact. But they felt this way, and their protest was exactly like that of the Palestinian Arab citizens here in the past few days. Precisely the same. Don't tell me any stories. I live in Israel. I see and hear things. I know what's going on. I saw the shattered glasses of shops everywhere here in the center of Rehovot in July 2019. July, August, summer 2019. I saw it, I remember it. Come on, don't tell me stories. And the Palestinian Arabs are the original population here from before the Israelis came, before the Jewish people came and created Israel. They are the natives. And they are really oppressed and discriminated against, really persecuted. They cannot even build their own houses where they choose. In most villages in Israel, they are not allowed to buy house. It's inconceivable. They truly are discriminated against. They truly are persecuted. But still, while the Ethiopian Jews protest in 2019 was received in all the understanding and compassion from the majority here, when the Arabs start to do something like that, almost all Jews demand to slaughter them and genocide them. Zero understanding, zero acceptance from the Zionists. And another example. The leftist, as left as it gets, the somewhat leftist party here, political party here, Meretz, is very vocally against any harm done to humans. Rightfully so. But they are pretty fanatic when it comes to that. For example, no one there, well, no one in any other party too, but I don't care about other parties. No one there would say, rape and murder, cool. We are liberal. We do not tell people how to have their fun in their own free time, in their homes. Let them rape, let them murder, let them murder. They do not say that. Never would. Never should. However, when it comes to non-human animals, yes, we will not force them to go vegan. We will not force people to go vegan. We are liberal. It's none of our business what's in their plate. It's not a question of plates. It's not a question of telling another person what can or what cannot be on their plate. It's a question of brutally murdering innocent animals or abusing them to death. I mean, they wouldn't dream of saying about a serial rapist, we will not intervene in what happens in their beds. They will not say that. But when it comes to animals, so animals are not human. I have these petitions about declaring snails snails, the cutest animal in the universe, declaring them to be protected animals. One petition in Hebrew regarding Israel, the other in English, global. And hardly anyone signs it. People care more about pure bullshit, pure nonsense, than they care about saving countless lives. Just because the lives in question happen to be snails. I simply cannot understand it. You care about saving lives of humans, care also about snails, about cats, about cows, about chickens, about tuna, whales, all beings. Caring just about one being is just like caring about one ethnic group and not the others. It's the same. Caring about one species but not about any other, it's similar to caring about one ethnic group and not the other. And as long as the people who call themselves left do not even understand this, I want nothing to do with them. Simple as that.